What is a purpose-driven workplace?
Millennials today are changing the workplace, and what they will say constantly is that they will choose workplaces that offer them a chance to align their values and their passions, even over ones that pay more. One of the most startling examples of a great place to work is Warby Parker. Warby Parker is this sexy, wonderful eyewear company, and millennials love this, and they flock to it, and they have fun fact meetings, and it's constantly seen as this wonderful place to work. It's really a glorified call center. It's selling eyewear over the internet in a few stores. It's a call center. This should not be a fun job, but it is, because they get it. And they get the fact that people want something that is making a difference in the world and where the spirit is both fun but purposeful. And it's not just millennials. Boomers want this too, and I think people in my Gen X demographic are struggling to balance their family lives and their professional lives. But the millennials, because they're entering the workforce with such passion, are really changing things. And this year there was a study of, I believe, 12,000 millennials asking them for the top places to work. Over half of the top 25 were government agencies and hospitals. Sitting at number one above Amazon, above Google, and above Disney, who are all in the top 10, number one, St. Jude Children's Hospital.
Okay.
And so I think that the companies of the future that allow people to feel a sense of meaning and purpose, and I'll go one step further, I think companies that allow flex time for both fathers and mothers and kids who are dealing with sick parents in the sandwich generation are going to be the workplaces of the future. And I think people who are just looking at Silicon Valley and whose foosball table and whose massage therapist can come in to keep people there longer are missing the point. I believe that the lessons we should learn about the most flexible workplaces are those that offer these things, the values, the passions, and the flexibility so that people can have lives and be good workers. These, I believe, are going to be the workplaces that succeed. I was talking at one of the top Wall Street banks, and I was meeting with the firm, but I was meeting with 30 top women beforehand, and they found it strange that I talked about my daughters, Tybee and Eden, all the time. And I said, well, why would you find that strange? And they said, well, here at the firm, we don't put up photos of our family for seeming disloyal, fear of seeming disloyal. And I thought, this is insane. So at the end of this hour-long discussion, we were talking many topics. They said, you have one piece of advice. I said, yes, put out your family photos. And I think fathers too, you know, often, even if there's a paternity leave, are scared to take it. I mean, they want to get to their bed, their children's bedtime. They want to get to the kids' little league practices and ballet recitals. But is it acceptable for fathers too? So number one, I think we have to move from making this a woman's issue to making this a worker's issue. And two, I hate the word balance. I find this incredibly stressful. But I think if we can integrate our work and our life, and if our kids know what we're doing when we're not with them, and if our workplaces know that we have families and we have lives and we are people, then I think that it's never going to be in perfect alignment, but at least we can feel like we can do both.